Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about summation notation, and in this particular problem we've been asked to just calculate the sum. So we've been told that the series starts at r equals 1, that it goes up to r equals 8, and we've been given this function, the quantity r minus 1 times the quantity r plus 2, and we've been asked to find the sum. So basically what we need to do is just plug in the numbers that we've been given. We know that the series starts at r equals 1, so that means first we're going to plug in 1 to this function here. Then we're going to plug in 2, then 3, then 4, all the way up to r equals 8, since we've been given 8 here in this position. So if we just write that out, then it's just going to be a matter of arithmetic, and that's always how you work with a sum like this. You start with the number here, plug that in for the variable, then count up by 1 until you get to this number here that you've been given on the top of your summation notation. So in our problem, we're going to get, and we'll just do this kind of without being real formal about it, but 1 minus 1 is going to be 0 times 1 plus 2 is 3. Then we add each time. So now we've got, now we'll be plugging in 2. So 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 plus 2 is 4. Then we add again. Now we're plugging in 3. 3 minus 1 is 2, 3 plus 2 is 5. And if we start to see here, right, we look at what we get when we plug it into this first quantity here, we're getting 0, 1, and 2. Plugging in for the second quantity, we're getting 3, 4, and 5. So we start seeing that pattern, and we can just continue writing that pattern. So we're getting 0, 1, 2, so that means this one's going to be 3. We've got 3, 4, 5, which means this one's going to be 6. And this is what we get when we plug in 4. So then we're adding 1 to both of these each time. So it's going to be 4 times 7. Plus 5 times 8, which is what we get when we plug in 6, plus 6 times 9, which is what we get when we plug in 7, and then our last value, which is 8, we get 7 times 10. That's what we get when we plug in 8. So now we just have to do the arithmetic here. So we're going to get 0, this is going to cancel, then we'll get 4 plus 10 plus 18 plus 28 plus 40 plus 54 plus 70. And when we add those together, we'll get 14, 24, 32, 52, 60, 100, 154, 224 is what we get when we add those all together. And that's it. That's our final answer. So again, you just use the function that you're given here. You start with this number down here, plugging that in first. In this case, it's 1, so you start plugging in 1, then 2, then 3. You count up until you get to the top number, which in our case was 8. That's when you stop, and then you just simplify with arithmetic or algebra until you get to your final answer. And in this case, the sum here was 224. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!